Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Today, my dear friends, today lecturers, Bapak Profesor Dr. Didi Setiadi MA and Bapak Hupung Purnawarman PhD. Today, we would like to present on the topic of test development and validation. But before we begin, I would like to introduce you to the members of our team. My name is Mugitri Pai, and I will be delivering the topic of test development. And my friend, Andreas Alkoroman, he will be presenting the topic of test validation. Okay, now we'll begin with the first subtopic, the test development. First, why we need to develop a new test? There are at least four reasons why we need to develop a new test. The first one is to meet the needs. So when a new need is raised, so we need to catch up to that. So that's why we need to develop a new test. And then next is to improve accuracy, especially when we have already developed a test earlier and then we evaluated the test and we found some inaccuracy, then we can improve the accuracy of the test by developing a new test. And then we can also develop a new test to sample behavior of a new test domain. So for example, like we have a new group of people to be tested, then we don't know how they respond to the test, and we can set a new test and we can develop a new test for them. And the last one is to revise the earlier test. So we have already had a trust instrument earlier, and then we found that there are some flaws and something like that, and we can revise the test and we develop a new one. Now, how do we develop a test? What are the stages of the test development? According to Hughes, 2002, there are at least 10 stages of test development. The first one is stating the problem. And then the next one is writing test specifications. Third is writing and moderating items. And next is trial on native speakers. Fifth, trial on the non-native speakers. And then sixth, analyze trial results. Seven, calibration of skills. And then next is validation. After that, writing handbooks. And the last is training staffs. Now we'll look at them one by one more carefully. The first stage, studying the problems. When we first try to develop a new test, we need to define what type of test are we going to have, and then what are actually the purposes of the test. And we also need to define what abilities are we going to test, and how much details of the test we needed, and also the accuracy of the test. In addition to that, we also need to define what is the benefit of the backwash effect. And lastly, we also need to define the constraints of the test in the sense where there are absence of technology, for example, or staff, something like that. So what are the constraints of the test? And after that, we go on to the next stage, writing specification. This include content, and then the structure. When we talk about structure, we need to specify whether we need how many numbers of items, and then how many alternatives when we have multiple choices and something like that. We also need to specify the timing and also the medium or the channel, whether we want to have this as a paper-based test or a computer-based test or an online test. And then we can also, we need to specify the technique and also the criteria levels and the scoring procedures. After that, we go into the third stage, which is writing and moderating items. First, we need to sample the items, not only so we need to write items not only from one or two areas, but we can try to write items from different areas. in order to have a more thorough test instruments. And then in writing a test, you need to be consistent. And lastly, moderation. In moderating items, we need to have at least two persons in deciding whether the item is good enough, need to be modified, or maybe even rejected. So at least we have to find out whether the test is reliable or good. And then on the next stage, we can do the trial on the the native speakers. And for the native speakers, they have to be similar in age, education, and general background. However, we can have this trial in informal situation. Like, it doesn't have to be a test condition. So it can be in their own situation. When an item is found difficult for active speakers, then it needs revision or maybe rejection. Then after going on trials on the native speakers, we can then have the items to be tried on the non-native speakers. But this time under a test condition to a similar group, similar to the groups that the test is intended for. Then we go on to the next stage. The sixth stage is analyzing the trial results. In the analysis, we can look at it from two different point of view. The first one is the statistical analysis, and the other one is the qualitative analysis. We have to analyze the results of the trial according to both analysis, statistical and qualitative. And then number seven, calibration of the scales. Especially when we write or we develop a writing or speaking test, we need to assign samples of the responses to scales. So this is to define whether certain response is included into which scale, A, B, C, or D, or maybe in numbers. So this is the calibration of scales. And then number eight, validation. This one will be explained later by my friend, but this is this really depends on the necessity. So for example, for tests who have high stakes of like for example, that will be used globally or in a large area, large context, and with numbers of test takers, then it's very essential. However, for test that is only for one institution, then it is still crucial, or yeah, it is still needed, it's still necessary. But for test which is only used for one time, once or twice, then it is not quite necessary, although still desirable. And then the ninth stage is writing handbooks. The handbooks are not only for test takers, but also for test users and staffs. And the handbook should include at least the rationale of the test, and then how it was developed and validated, and the descriptions of the test. And also it also has to include sample items and also the advice on how to prepare the test. Also explanation of score interpretation, training materials, and test administration. And lastly, the last stage is training staffs. In this stage, we need to train staffs, especially like interviewers, scorers, raters, computer operators, or even proctors on how to administer the test and how to give scores, how to rate the responses of the test takers, and how to organize the test and to produce the result. Okay, that is the end of my presentation. The next presentation will be delivered by my friend, Andreas. Thank you very much. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.